It's about losing control.
Who can ever forget the super talented and beautiful black butterfly Tsakani TK Mhinga, singer, songwriter and arranger whose unique sound presented a blend of South African Kwaito music and soulful R&B. Gone too soon, but certainly never forgotten. Thank you so much for checking out 21 Isakhuv Avenue. Please don't forget to subscribe to our channel and to hit the notifications bell so you never miss out on our latest content. We take a trip down memory lane to revisit some iconic moments in South African art and music history. Let's roll it. Born on the 23rd of November 1978 in Soweto, Tsakani was the eldest of four children of Batsonga royalty Hosi Xilungwa and Tebogo Mhinga. She would later become R&B royalty, and this became clear as early as age 12 when Tsakani performed a heartwarming rendition of Over the Rainbow during a school talent competition, a song cover she eventually got to record and later share with the world. Fast forward to 1999, TK stepped onto the South African music scene when she was featured by the late Zimbabwean rapper Mischief on his single Place for a Wife. Fresh out of high school, TK was determined to make a name for herself in the music industry. Despite her family's disapproval for her chosen career path, TK went to sign with local record label to release a debut album titled TKO in 2000. The album, which infused elements of soul R&B and South African Kwaito music, featured the popular hit single Mind Your Business, a chart-dominating club anthem, went on to win a South African Music Award for Best R&B Album, a title which iconically became the common thread amongst all of TK's albums. You're a pimpin' on the street. I was analyzing all the scenes. If two can play this game that you already started, then why must I cry? Cause these tears won't save me. In 2001, TK released a second and self-titled album, Tsakani, with sassy hit offering Eject Your Ass, a powerful statement to a boy who stood her up at 5:15. Apparently, the number caught on like wildfire amongst club DJs, and TK went on to win her second summer for Best R&B Album consecutively. Black Butterfly, the crown jewel to the star's discography, was released in April 2003. It would become TK's final project, giving us timeless hits like How Do You Feel featuring Twist Style and the title track Black Butterfly, which won a Summer Award for Best Arrangement, while the album scooped yet another Best R&B title. At this point, TK had cemented herself as a musician, and it was clear to industry peers that her vocal highness had indeed arrived. Some notable moments in TK's career include opening for international stars Deborah Cox and Kid Sweat at the height of her musical success. Sadly, her stardom was short-lived. TK's musical journey came to an abrupt stop on 27th February 2006, when the R&B sensation was found dead in her Bryanston hotel room, leaving behind her 3-year-old son.
Where did I go wrong?
Drug overdose was the suspected cause of the star's untimely death. At the time, TK was set to start working on what would have been her 4th album.
And I cannot help but wonder, did I miss the big parade?
It's been nearly 2 decades since her passing, but TK's sultry voice still lingers, sending shivers down his spine every time her songs are played on the radio.
There are certain things I wish that you could see.
TK's undeniable contribution to the South African music industry is one for the history books. And her legacy lives on through her timeless music.
But love, you see it come.